Today is November 30th. Here's my next project. I got some 2-inch angle iron, 3/16 thick, two sticks of it, 20 feet long. Had them cut it for me so I could fit it in the trailer. But and then some expanded metal. So what I'm going to do is build a 6-foot wide, because that's what my trailer is, by 4-foot long ramp for this. I don't have the pin stock yet, you know, the little probably half inch tube and then pin, but I'll find that. I might have some half inch pipe here already, but I'll find something to use for that to hinge it, obviously. But these boards are, it's cumbersome to deal with them, to get our dirt bikes off and on the trailer, and kind of dangerous. You know, having a nice wide ramp will be much better. So, all right, here we go. All right, so I've got my angle iron in here. I had them cut it so that it came in a 20-foot stick. So I had them cut it at 12 feet, leaving the other 8 feet on there, because my dimensions for the trailer ramp are going to be 62 inches wide, not 6 feet wide. So I'll get both of those pieces out of one of these 12s. And then I'm gonna brace it, or it's gonna be 4 feet long, I guess you'd call it. And I'll have, you know, of course, one 4-foot long piece on either side. And then I'm gonna brace it with three in the middle. So what I'm gonna do now is just mark this up and cut this piece into two 62 inch pieces for my width. All right, here we go. I'm gonna start cutting. Put my hearing protection on. There's the first piece, so that's 62 inches long. I'm gonna cut another one, and then I'll get back with you guys. I won't bore you with all these cuts. So, I have our two 62-inch pieces that go the width of the trailer, and then I've got six 48-inch pieces, two for the outsides, and then I decided, because I had enough angle, that I would put a brace at basically every foot, except for the first one's at 13 inches. Then 12, then 12, then 12, then 13 again, and that gives you 62 inches. So I've got some nice bracing, basically spaced a foot apart. That should really probably handle anything that I want to try to pull on the trailer. So, all right, at this point, I'm going to lay out the rectangle and clamp it up and get ready to weld. And I'll show you that here in a minute. All right, so what I'm getting ready to do here is turn the radio down for one thing. Happy golden days of yore. Alright, what I'm getting ready to do is, like I said, the width of the trailer is basically 62 inches on the ID of it, the way it's framed and everything. So I'm going to be putting the 4-foot pieces on the outside so it covers the edge of the angle. and look nicer. So consequently, the thickness of the material is 3/16, so that gives you 6/16, which is 3/8 of an inch. So if I leave 62 inches on the two pieces that are within the trailer, that's going to get me too close to the actual width of the ID. So I'm going to cut a quarter of an inch off, so it ended up being 61 3/4 wide instead. You know, that way I have some flex room. If there's no flex room at all, then it could be problematic trying to close the thing and so forth. So I'm going to do that and then get back to clamping up and get ready to weld. All right, I've got this thing clamped up. I don't know if you can see this or not, but this is like a pair of vice grips type of clamp. It's for, you know, welding. I've used these several times. I have a couple of pair of them anyway. Got them at Harbor Freight. They're pretty cheap. So come in real handy. I've also got this woodworking thing I use for woodworking, where you want to keep, like, if you're planing or something, you want the board to come out and hit the top of this so that it supports it. So I've got that supporting this 4 foot piece. I use my carpenter square, making sure everything's nice and square before I commit to welding it. So, which brings me to that. I'm going to use an old stick welder. I bought this thing off of a guy, I don't know, 25 years ago in Millington for $35. The guy had it. I saw it in his garage. I think he might have had a for sale sign on it, but anyway, the thing is the old Sears Roebuck. It's, you know, I think Methuselah used it or something, but I'll show you what this thing looks like. Get this camera down here. There it is in all its glory. So the only thing I did to it was put a plug on it so I could use it, and you know, it's obviously 220. But the cords on it are, you know, they definitely need to be replaced, but I don't use the thing that much, and I just have never replaced the cables on it. But it works. It's just every once in a while, if you're not careful, you might get shocked. So anyway, I'm going to use it to weld things up. So, but before I do that, I am going to dress the metal here with a grinding wheel, hand grinder, just to get some nice, fresh, clean metal and wipe it off, so I get a nice, good weld that's gonna hold and not, because if the metal's not clean, it may look like it's got a good weld, but the weld didn't stick. It didn't adhere well enough to the dirty metal, so it can actually, you know, break on you and stuff. So of course we don't want that. So I'm gonna go ahead and clean this up and then begin welding. Here we go. Here we go. I'm gonna start welding. Watch your eyes. What I'm doing when I'm welding, by the way, this is 1/8 inch stick. It's the technical name for it's an arc welder. It just, you know, I call it a stick welder. Most welders do as well, I think. Anyway, I'm not a welder though, so what do I know? But what I'm doing is I was taught by my late and best friend Claude to weld. So what I do know how to do is all from him. But so I'm making tiny little circles, and then I'm following the seam of where it is I'm trying to weld together. So I'm just making circles with the stick as I go along. So I've got the outside of this welder, now I'm gonna weld the inside. Here we go. All right, I wanted to show what I'm doing here to get the metal prepped. So I use my handheld grinder to just kind of clean the metal up. So when I go to weld down, you know, inside there, obviously all of this, all the way out, didn't need to be cleaned, but I just took it where I knew I'd be welding to, for sure, on both sides. So, and then I'm gonna clean up this piece, which I've already cut to 61 3/4 inches to match the other side over there. So hopefully everything comes up nice and square.
All right. Yeah, I wanted to show you the finished weld here. So what I did is I got it from the outside at the seam right there, and then along the seam down in there, as well as in the inside corners. Actually, I didn't get that corner right there, but that's okay. I got it down here and up through there. So a little bit, got a little bit heavy on this area here, but it doesn't matter. It doesn't have to be pretty. So looks like I might hit it a little bit more right there in the center and then kind of grind that back. But basically I'm gonna do that again on the other side with a 4 foot piece. And then I'll have to shave down 1/4 inch on this 62 inch piece here so that it's the same length as this one. Once I get that all welded together, then it'll be the reinforcement, you know, the braces. So I may or may not do any more coverage of the welding, because basically you saw what I did there. And I just, after I got done welding, I just ground it back a little bit, so it's a little bit prettier. So anyway, all right, we'll catch you soon. All right, so I've got these clamped up, and everything's coming out nice and square, so you won't see any issues there. Yeah, nice and square. So go ahead and get these welded, and the frame will be done. And then, like I said, I'm just gonna go bracing down through there, and then once that's all done, I'll flip the thing up. Well, my boys, they'll do the heavy lifting for me on account of my, I've got a back issue. Anyway, they'll turn it over for me, and I'll be able to weld on the expanded metal. So, all right, here we go. A little bit of cleanup here. All right, so that was just to get ready for, you know, so I got good clean metal for the welding process. And I don't have ground. Gotta have a ground to weld.
If I can adjust the camera here. I think it's down far enough.
Like I said,
that all I'm doing is just making little tiny circles. Time to get stuck. And I'm holding the wand at a slight angle. I'm not straight onto it. Here I'm doing a little bit of a stitch weld back and forth because there's a little bit of a gap between the two pieces of angle as they come together at a 90. So I'm stitch welding. A little bit at a time. It's got to cool down. Otherwise we'll just continue to burn the metal. Basically, welding is just melting metal against itself, and it's using the rod as a medium to do that. I'm going to finish this up and I'll get right back. All right, good morning. This is December 1st and I've got my expanded metal here. Of course, from yesterday, I got the frame of the ramp welded up. So what I'm getting ready to do now is cut the expanded metal to fit the ramp. But I decided to do this a slightly different way. What I'm going to do, instead of attaching the expanded metal to the outside of the ramp, I'm going to put it on the inside of the ramp and then put my braces across. That way, it's going to be held in by the braces that are going, actually, 4-foot braces this way. So I'll have to recut those braces maybe an eighth of an inch shorter so they'll fit down in there. And then this will actually have to be cut a little bit under the dimension, the outside dimension of the ramp. So I'm gonna get this all set up and ready to cut, and I'll be back. All right. So what I'm doing is cutting right where the diamond, I would call it, meets the other diamond, just at each spot there, and removing that little bit, and hopefully it'll sit inside the frame of the thing. Okay, here's that bit that I cut off, so about an inch, I guess that'd be about an inch. And so now I just got to cut the width of it for the proper length. Yeah. Width of it so it fits down in the frame. All right.
so I got that cut off. And about an inch, I guess, is what I took off. All right, I got some sharp edges here now. So I'm gonna go ahead and take those down with this ball peen hammer, just so I don't get cut. All right, so there it is. I got the expanded metal inside the frame, and so now I'm going to brace it in this direction with four braces, hopefully evenly spaced. So I'll have to get some measurements here. Here we go. All right, I got a little bit ahead of myself. So before I mark this out, I've actually got to cut the braces themselves so that they fit inside the ID of the ramp. So my measurement here is just over, looks like it's 47 5/8, 5/8, 11/16, I'll say. But I'm gonna back that out to 5/8. So each one of the braces, the four braces, has to be 47 5/8, so they'll sit down in here. And so what's gonna happen is when I put those in place and weld them, they're gonna hold the expanded metal itself in. So there's no, and it kind of creates a nicer, you know, there's less risk of if it were welded to the outside of the trailer where you're running your dirt bike or riding mower or whatever. You know, you might run a risk of the expanded metal popping up or something and then creating some kind of a tire hazard or human hazard, what have you. So I think this is going to be nicer. The only thing it's going to do is it will put the brace a little bit proud of this plane right here on the outside, you know, of the frame. So just by about, you know, maybe an eighth of an inch, but it doesn't matter because the only thing I'll have to do is where the ramp lays down on the ground, I may want to just kind of shave with the grinder, shave it away a little bit so it sits more flat, but I'll, you know, evaluate that when I get there. So I'm going to get these measured up, 47 5/8, and get them cut, and then we'll go from there. All right. To wait in the cold for repair. So don't accept stand. I got all those marked out, so what it turned out to be is, like I have before, 13 inches, then 12, and then 13 inches from that edge, and that gives you the 62, so things are equally spaced. Now, what I did do, because I'm into aesthetics as well, is I turned the flat facing this way, and this one as well, but then changed it to go this way. And so there's a little bit more of a gap right here than the other ones, but you know, the symmetry of it looks right. So it's ready to go. So all I gotta do is I'll go ahead and clamp each end and then tack weld them and pull the clamp off and then weld it the rest of the way. Here we go. Thank you.
about stick welding I don't like. With stick like that.
Thing about stick welding I don't like is when you try to get that wand or the stick to ignite and start welding, oftentimes you get too close to the metal and it'll actually pull it in or hold it there and you get stuck. So it's sort of like striking a match. You have to kind of move like you're striking it but getting off of it again, but I still haven't mastered that. So anyway, I'm just welding up all these braces here. I got two of them done. This is the third one I'm working on right now. So that's the process. I'm basically just welding it anywhere I can get a weld. Not necessarily all across the seam, but like at the beginning of it and at the end of it. But it's a little bit hard to do it at this angle. I don't know why it is, but seems like I had better, like it went smoother yesterday. I'm not getting as pretty a weld here today, but again, I'm not trying to win a beauty contest as long as it's strong. So, all right, see you in a bit. All right, it's all welded up now. So, got some pretty good welds on here on both the both sides of the angle here and along this edge. And then at the very, very top against the outside of the angle. And so what I'm going to do now is I'm going to call that the part that is going to touch down on the ground. So what I'm going to do is where this is sticking up, probably about a quarter of an inch actually, I'm going to grind it back, not just on that corner, but a little bit back in here too, because it's going to help it sit down on the ground a little flatter. Even though it'll still be off the ground is, this little 2 inch here, but that's not a problem if you're gonna pull the motorcycle, dirt bike up in there, or the lawnmower or something like that. That's no problem at all. So anyway, I'm just kind of clean that up, kind of grind those down a little bit and make it a little bit nicer. So, all right, here we go. Let me show you what I've done. So let's see. You can see that there. I'm just kind of creating a little bit of a rounded or angled edge there, so it transitions to the ground a little bit better. Rather than having that point. Let's see if I can get that. Yeah, see that point sticking up there. Rather than have that, it's going to be a little bit tapered down a little bit. I might ease that down a little bit more even, but that's what I'm going to do to all four of those. Obviously I can't do much. I guess I could do a little bit on the corners too. Yeah, I might think about that. These gloves are falling apart. Anyway. All right. So took off a little bit more than I did at first. 'Cause I wanted it to be even, you know, a little more transition. So if you look down those, I didn't mark them really. I just kind of eyeballed it. But you can see where there's, where it kind of transitions. Excuse me. Down to the bottom edge, of the whole ramp. Excuse me. I got a little bit of a cold. So I did that to all four on the ground side, what would be the ground side. And then I also did a little bit of that to a lesser degree on the trailer side. A little lesser degree, just to kind of take those corners off so they're not so, you know, don't present any kind of a hazard. So anyway, at this point, what I have to do is weld the tube, which will serve as the hinge to both the ramp and then the trailer. But let's see. I might do that. Might do that here. Obviously, I'm gonna need my boys to lift this thing up for me, so I can't really do anything with it right now. But anyway, I think rather than show all that, what I'm gonna do is explain what I'll do. It's gonna be like a 6-inch piece, 4-inch piece maybe, that will be about right in here at the very top edge of the ramp, and then one over here, and then the other one on the trailer respectively, so that a pin can go in there. And I'm just going to be using a 1/2-inch round stock and then a 1/2-inch ID black pipe, and hopefully I don't have any issues welding that up. But that's going to do it. So once I get all that done, I'll show a final picture of everything, and that'll wrap this project up, besides painting it, of course. All right, we'll catch you guys next time.